just easy as.
Finally, I'm home. Oh dear lord. How do you plan on the mouse things? Crap. It's like old man Henry's in the shower right now. Old man Henry, why are you naked? You better be wearing shorts in there, buddy. About the world of books, like you actually go into the book and explore it. So hopefully we get to go into Moby Dick and I can call him a Mobiusticus. Because that is my favorite. The kitchen is still at work, still a work in progress. It's been a while. Are you expecting anyone, honey? No, mother. Could it be the mailman? This early? Go see who it is. There's a man here, mother. Is the door locked? I don't. It's our neighbor. I'm doing well, thanks. Nice day. I bought a scrub daddy, which came today. Nice! So I gotta try that out. It really is really great. My groceries arrived too, so my fridge and freezer are packed. Nice! That's what mom and I did. We had an appointment this morning. Got to go see everything for the surprise. Very nice surprise, and then we went grocery shopping. So you need to get more meat and everything. Clover is exhausted because she had a very busy day too. Hi, Swirl. Hi, Mom. How you doing? But that's awesome. Henry? No, Mother. The rider, remember? Don't open the door. He has no business coming around here. What if he needs help? Is he injured or something? I don't think so. He just looks a little roughed up. He can take care of himself. You can't be too careful around these parts, even when it comes to the neighbors. Fine. Go fuck yourself! He's a dang writer! Ooh, that guy's... Oh, wait. Is that my apartment? I have an eviction notice? I, like, stepped away for 2 seconds, man. Risk compensation of property, now eviction. Mr. Quist, this is a reminder that you may begin working off your sentences any time by registering with any licensed publishing agency. In the event you work off the full sentence, you will be released from the preventative measure in the form of shackles that impose writer's block on you. Any other attempts to remove the shackles other than those provided by the law will be considered a violation of your sentence and will entail consequences. Your sentence will be re-examined with exaggerating circumstances, City Writers Police Department. We got a whole police department for a writer? What? Just gonna close my door. No, I don't care. I literally just got it. How do you know I'm not in the shower with Mr. Henry? Alright? I'm not in Mr. Henry's shower. Let me rephrase that. I'm just in the shower with Mr. Henry. Independence Bookstore, letter by letter, has announced that it is putting all the Bob and Quince's works for sale. Well, it's pulling. The store's owner, Raymond Farquist, commented, unfortunately, Mr. Quince's writing license. Apologize to his fans, as Mr. Quint's books enjoyed a certain popularity. I do hope that Mr. Quint can solve the problems he is facing, and that we'll have his books back on the store shelves as soon as possible. So the man has writer's block. That's not how that works. That's not how that works, guys. Interesting, but I don't care. Hang up. Leave a message. Bathroom is locked. I have to pay for water. I don't think they can just lock your bathroom. As I expected, they confiscated everything. Well, time to jump out the window. If it wasn't by a wall. Yeah, they got everything except... Too early to go to bed. I have work to do. I'm not answering the dang phone. I don't care. I just got in. away from the ringing sounds. Oh, the bees! The author of this book? Are we putting a hit out on him? Is this a Hitman game? I wasn't aware of it. An excerpt from the book reviews. I liked that the narration was from the point of view of the book's supposed villain, but the characters fighting against him just weren't interesting enough in comparison. I also enjoyed the ending, sappy as it was. That's just rude. How dare they? Looks like this is where the stolen item goes. And a freeze-dried... You know what? It's fine. Let's go in! Down the rabbit hole Alice goes. If only my name were actually Alice. Oof. Stone floor makes your bad knee twist awkwardly. Dude, I feel that one. Use ink to heal yourself. You reach down and touch your bad knee. You start visualizing the ink flowing into the injured joint and healing it. Ow! Sudden icy cold. Freezing seizes your wrists. I forgot about the stupid shackles. You examine the metal bracelets around your wrists and the writing etches on the surface. Now I'm just as powerless as a plain old character. You are unable to heal your knee. I don't know what the second one says. Hold on. Leave your knee like it is, and then... Haha! Force your knee back into place! Let's do it. That hurts too, trust me, I know. You take a deep breath and sharply wrench your knee to the side. Yep. Ow! Yep. You bend your knee this way and that a few times, testing it. The crunching sound has stopped. Phew. Anyways, let's get down to business. I need to find the portion of immortality to take it out of here. Listen, I'm not gonna be limping. I do that enough. Nothing but bones left. No potions. It's locked. Lockpick will sure come in handy. Kick the door. Step away from the door. Kick the door. Nothing happens except that your not quite healed knee starts hurting again. Oh. Might as well try hitting it with my head at this rate. Hesitate for a second. Headbutt the door anyway. Step away from the door. Step away from the door. Is that a bomb? Whoa, two heads? What kind of strange show is this? Craft parts. Use food to regain health. Prisoner's helmet. Oh! Spite for the outside, smooth and foul smelling on the inside. Well, you know. Is it already on him? Jason Little, 28. Potion P4 causes unpredictable mutations. Results unpredictable. Client, the Kingdom of Riviere, unknown use. Production volume 1 unit. Well, cool. I doubt the potion of immortality is just going to be laying around at the ordinary barrel. But, let's kick the barrel. Get ready to kick! Oh, there's apple and apple core. Cool. Crowbar parts. And apple core. Old note, if you're lucky, they might rust or test a poison potion of immortality on you. What is there to think about? Just say yes. Do you really want to live forever? I surely don't. Lockpick would sure come in handy. I'm pretty sure I had a lockpick or something. I could use one at least. I need to go back to my reality and check my room. Art, he is wake up. Jeez, really? You went in the book without the lockpicking tools? What is wrong with you? And here's a lockpick. Can't you just take the shackles off of you that way? Sorry, hydrating. Okay. Back into the book. Look at that! Slowly test all the pins in the lock with your lockpick until you finally hear a click. And we're out! What the? And there's a dead guy! He's dead. Your gaze travels to the wound on the walker's forehead. That looks like a bullet hole. The capsule around the dead man's neck starts vibrating and you hear a soft voice coming from inside it. What?! Nice one, Sherlock. Go fuck yourself! Who are you? Sorry for interrupting you. You were just saying something about my partner here. Go ahead, continue. He's your partner? We were on our first job, but it didn't end well. I'm sorry. Hang on, who are you? A character? Yes, I think so, sir. But you're aware that you're a character. Of course. What do you mean, of course? It doesn't work like that! You try and use the light to illuminate the contents of the cage, but all you see inside is a scrap of paper. That's what all my past partners said, too. Past partners? How many have you had? You turn the capsule over and look at the base, but all you find are half-legible inscriptions. Not that many. My first partner sold me to my second partner after an unfortunate incident. I ended up peeing the cage. You like it? Okay. Until I ended up with a partner who died. Yeah. Fortunately, a new partner found me and we started working together. Mm-hmm. Wait, are you calling me your third partner? That's correct! We're partners now, sir! You look at the walker's body again. Sure. I'll hang it around my neck for now, then figure out what to do with you later. Wonderful, I'm back in business, baby! Hi, Kay, how are you? Hello, hello! Boop! We are delving into books. It's called Bookwalker. We're called Bookwalker, but... I'm exhausted. How are you guys? Pretty much the same. It was really fun though last night. I enjoyed it. What the heck? I may drag some objects around. Can I drag this guy? Crowbar parts. Hold on, I gotta go get another drink. Hold on. I wasn't prepared for this. Thank you. Thank you. arrived a bang energy tea, but I already had some coffee this morning, so I don't think that'll be a good thing. So I got a Coca-Cola instead. A little tiny one. Oh, thank you. What can I drag around? He's just stopping in random spots. Oh, I'm dragging barrels. Oh, I got it. Okay. I don't got it. I thought I got it. I have to hold it. Yeah, that's fine. There's an ordinary power cable running through here. Doing in the old-timey jail. That's the book's big twist. I don't want to ruin it for you. Just ruin it for me. Feel where it goes to use something. Smack the little jar thing until it pees and tell you. Use pillars to cut the cable, or pliers to cut the cable. Throw caution to the wind and pull it out of the wall. Wake up and see if I have any pliers. Alright. Do I have any pliers left on my... Maybe may I go knock on neighbors' walls and be like, hey! Can I borrow your pliers?
Yeah, you
got work to do. Yeah. See if old man Henry's still showering. Alright, we're back. Like I said, I at least know how to fix that one. Still on a high from yesterday, Frank. Same! That was really fun, it really was. And you're lucky, Kay, you gotta go up against the night. I didn't get a chance to see the night at all. We're gonna have to... Listening was so much fun. It really was. And thank you again. You guys are so very generous, and I don't deserve any of that, and I don't know how to tell you that I appreciate it all, other than just saying the words. Alright, so there's no flyers, so we're just gonna throw caution to the wind and pull it out. By the 220 volts running through the cable. I knew there was a catch. Never again. Well, Jax, it was a little sad. We played a couple matches after you left immediately. The first one was against the knight. I'll play the knight, but I don't want to play against him. Oh, my goodness. It's okay, because I still haven't gone against the knight or the lady with the drones. So That's alright. Well, eventually I will. It was wild. He has, like, companion NPCs. Oh, yeah. His friends. I read about them. That help hunt you down. There's, like, four killers instead of one. Wow. Sir, what are you doing? That's awesome. Yeah, because I've read like the little killer wikis, like the Dead by Daylight wiki, so I knew he had companions. But I wanted to see how it was gonna be. His name was Brian. Did you know him? No, but you can read about him on the sign in the hallway. Sure, next time I'm here. If. No, I don't want to move the stupid barrels. I want to go through the... Okay, apparently I can just get zapped and that's it. Yes, only two, I think. It was awful. I think he only got one or two gens done before he got all of us. Oh my goodness. George Hamsterfell. Potion tested, eater 12. Results a mutation that allowed the subject to consume almost all known materials. Client anonymous. Personnel use. Reduction volume 1 unit. Got rags. I got crowbar parts, lockpicks, papers, mushroom, coin. Trash. Okay. Sounds like that was a one-sided game in their favor. Oh yeah. Definitely, I would say he's one of the ones that would be extremely hard to even do anything against. Another crowbar part? Sweet. The bed and mattress have been chewed straight through. Okay. The chain leads down somewhere. You could use something heavy as a counterweight to raise whatever's on the other end. Apple in a bottle. Okay. Just saw your message in the family chat. Yes.